next Friday, this has to be loaded onto a trailer, shipped out to Vegas.
What is it?
The wheel! Woo!
Woo! See where we had the McDonald's ass roof.
Today's Friday. Next Friday, this has to be loaded onto a trailer, shipped out to Vegas. We have 5 working days left. Good news is last night we fired it up, Team 6ix9ine, and the Honda HPD guys were here. We were here pretty late. You wouldn't know anything about that, Kyle, because you left early. But we were here late. We went through the gears. The transmission works. Everything works. All our systems are good. All the panels are ready to be put back on, so everything has to be fit and finished. We got to put on the hood today, send this stuff up to get painted again. This is the home stretch, and this is like the part where everybody fails. We get to this big picture, and then all the little details drop out because you're trying to rush. We're trying not to drop out the little details. Okay. So this is make or break. This is when the car comes together and it's a nice car or it's a piece of shit. We don't build pieces of shits.
And you know what that means? 30 to 50% off all sorts of shit on the site. We even got free gifts. And this year, we're bringing back something radical. This OMP Hoonigan steering wheel. Available starting Friday at Hoonigan.com. Shift knobs, gloves, toe strap belts, shirts, cars. All this and more at Hoonigan.com. Do the thing. It's Black Friday, so nothing's gonna last. Black Friday!
It's gonna be our on and off switch for all the power. So we're not having like 20 ring terminals on the battery. We can just come straight off the lugs on these. So we're opening up our real coilovers that we're using. These are from Motun. These are serious. So what's great about these, we're gonna go out to the track after we've installed all these. And these guys are gonna come out and they're gonna help us set up these shocks. Because one of the most important things about having a nice set of shocks like these is they have a ton of adjustment in almost every way. So first things first, we gotta get our springs. Soupy, do we ever get springs? We got iBox springs that we're gonna pair with these. So for now, springs, purchase, put them on the truck. And that's what we're doing right now. I gotta take the springs and the helper springs off of our old shock, put them on the Motons, because these are the right spring rate. So, now, I need your help again, Kyle. You know what, just go one hand. All right, let her go. Oh, I think it might work out. I think I fixed it. There's one of blue thread lock. All your nuts and bolts on a thing that's gonna be shaking around a bunch. Just a dab is all you need. This isn't the final setup, of course, but everything's symmetrical. All the lengths and distances are the same. The preload is set the same. Fasteners going in the same direction. you know, it's just one of those things. Those little details go a long way.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, this is Pennzoil Ultra Platinum Zero W40. Now, as far as an oil goes, awesome. Here's why. One, this off-the-shelf oil is the exact same oil used in Honda's Indy program. 12,000 RPM, turbo V6 is screaming for hours on end. If it can protect that, it can protect your jalopy. Significantly improved circulation on startup, and with the 40, it means you get that sustained high heat protection and lubrication that you need when you're banging limiter and, again, your jalopy. Best part is, it's even carbon neutral, so you can feel good about using it. Go get you some. Stay lubricated.
Did you mention 5 working days left before SEMA?
For the hood pin. Here.
And this, just screw in right here. And the nut will jam down.
There it is.
Boom.
Boom.
Together, yeah.
What's going on, man?
Test fit Friday, as they say.
So what do we bring today?
We brought one front and one rear of the centers for these two-piece forged wheels that we're doing. Special Hoonigan Edition Rotiform LTN.
Nice touch.
Yeah, so this is fresh out of the mill. You can still see all the tooling marks. Center lock in the rear, 5 lug in the front. Not your normal combo.
No.
First we'll polish them, then there's a lot of fire involved, weld up the backside, and it'll be essentially a two-piece welded forged wheel. It's pretty cool.
Nice.
So Monday, 5 more days until SEMA. Actually, no, Monday, yeah, 4 more days, because it actually... All the pieces are painted except for the hood and stuff, but we're just doing the final fit and finish. We're actually okay. Grim is working on the rear spoiler. These guys are finishing up the doors. We're pretty confident, maybe. The guys from Advanced Fiberglass Concepts came back with our spoiler end plates in carbon. They don't just do fiberglass, don't let that name fool you. This is the end plate. Imagine the wheel here. That big pocket here, that's for the stock Ridgeline taillight, because you know, you need taillights. Grim is actually working on the mount for this right now. We also done in carbon, but that's gonna be pressed carbon. We're gonna machine it out like our seat brackets. And that's it. Like, we have tons of little things left. I think we're down, we should be okay in 4 days.
Every time, so scary.
What's the thing in the thing?
Nice and smooth right in there.
Final assembly?
Hopefully. I say hopefully and then we're gonna be here tomorrow. Watch.
It's final mock-up.
Final mock-up.
The zip tie stage. Tuck everything away, make sure the lengths are right. No, we're really just following Matt's lead right now. We're just plebes.
Well, the problem is that,
like, see? See how he's like, yeah.
You go down.
Soupy
you
know? Jr.
What's up?
We got the door latch working. Whole mechanism we made. I made. Sorry.
Thanks, Soupy.
Yeah, thanks, Soupy. Was Was it this difficult during building battle?
Yeah, I think I was worse during building battle.
Yeah, that was.
We got the new front coilovers going on. We had a set of shocks on there for fitting it up. I designed it off of those ones. But luckily, these guys, can you believe it? But luckily, Moton, I just had to send them a couple specs, and they're able to send us a direct replacement pair. It uses a smaller spring, so now I have more clearance on the steering joint.
By a quarter length.
And this guy, which, Jamie, you son of a bitch, you put this in the wrong spot. Oh, here you go. I'm gonna mount these guys just like this. And that's gonna look real fresh. We can just come in here and just change our settings. Oh my God, so easy. Couple zip ties, call it a day, Kyle. That's what
couple
we're gonna do.
Zip ties, forget about it.
Why? Why? End plates, look at that.
Bolt that bad boy on like that, and then that is what holds the wing stand up on there, just like that. Okay, my hand's shaking.
Now we just gotta make it all fit together.
We got super glue.
That's hot.
Problem is that the wing mounts are so big, so it comes out to like right here. So we just need to do like a little bend here. Boop, 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 boop.
Paper the side.
Yeah, we might have to paper where the weld is. Yeah, I had that planned.
There you go.
How the hell do you mount this thing?
I have some self-tappers in the van. For help.
We might have to get them self-tappers out the soupy way.
Deck screw.
Yeah. Oh man, you should see it. Half of the warthogs held together by drywall screws.
I've heard.
All the wood stuff.
How are you gonna mount it?
Drywall screws. That's what we're doing. This we're good.
Just another day, another shift.
Look what we got
in the mail today. One of two of our K&N filters. These are the final K&N filters, not those cone filters we use to test fire the engine.
You do not approve.
Oh.
Dude, what? Don't touch it.
Don't mind all the problems. I just changed a couple sizes. This is what we're making today. This filter, that's gonna plop down inside of this box. It's gonna have this little lid with slots so we can push it down, bolt it in. And that guy is gonna go in front of our turbocharger. We're gonna use our K&N filter. Gonna have a nice little box. Gonna look really good when we're done with it.
Ladies, what's up?
Grimby bussin', hit him up.
Hit him up in the DM.
Hell yeah, Kyle, that's how you do it.
Let's go.
Touches off on the bottom, because these things will sag if you don't have something on the bottom like that. The middle will tend to sag down like that.
Why is the bag still on?
Because I want to keep the finish protected.
What a nerd. Got me fired up.
Oh, I'm fired up.
I'm inspired.
This thing is sick.
Back.
How far back do you need it?
This is the best way to do it.
Debatable.
Okay, enlighten us.
This should have went this way.
Strongest, safest way.
It's not. So now you can only bring the seat back to here.
What kind of giant is gonna be driving this thing? 7 feet tall.
Yeah. Dude, cut these off.
No, don't cut these off.
Oh, be careful.
I just had to like smooth them out a little bit because we had to hammer it down with a metal hammer. It's all smooth now. It's welded out.
Dude, that looks good as
fuck.
Just gotta hold your piece of paper like this.
Oh. It is about 9 o'clock on a Tuesday night. Shop is still bustling.
Getting this thing all dressed out. I don't know what else to say.
Yeah. Well, we have to tell everybody that Kyle left.
Oh yeah, Kyle did leave. Now we have to
drop what we're doing to film this.
To film this. Thanks, Kyle.
Get this going. 3 more days, including today.
Bottom. Are you doing both of them there?
Yes.
No. That's gross.
How is this gross?
How do you like rationalize it's gross?
Easy install.
No, it's gross.
I hate this, by the way.
I like it.
This is terrible.
That means it's working.
No, that means this way.
Or,
that's not the style, it's
perfect. Dude, you drive a G35.
I drive a 350Z.
Worse.
I'm rolling a G35.
Got a little ahead of myself. I should have painted it.
A little ahead of yourself?
Easy. Steering wheel buttons. We got our detailer. We got the Honda guys. We got Don coming back. It's chaos. I watched last year's episode this morning just to kind of have a sense of where we were this time last year. And I think we're in a better position. Right, Grim? Last year, 2 days before SEMA, we didn't have a painted car. So at least this year it's painted, sort of. Today, it's Grim's turn to be upset. Unboxing video.
Wait, what is it?
It's a wheel. Whoa. Yo, they forgot to drill the lugs. Oh yeah, center on.
Dang.
Yo, those are some bigums.
You gotta put the rotor form upright.
Hold on!
No!
The thing turns!
What? This is better than
So the front, we're still using the stock NSX 5x120 with the lug, right? So as soon as you go to the back, single lug out back.
You know, it's like a mullet.
Business in the front, party in the back.
You did that kick roll. You had a mullet at one point. You had a mullet.
Wait, wait, hold on. Just do it. Just do it.
The wheel is really nice. That's, I don't know, what do you got? They're shiny, they're chrome. That shit would look great on my Camaro.
Oh, come on.
All big, 19.
Oh!
You know what that is, Kyle?
The hitch.
So now we can put shit in there just like a normal truck. It's a real truck now. Gotta take the wing mounts off. And then this is where these guys are gonna thread into. 1, 2, 3 right there. That came out nice though.
Can you get your pin in? Oh my God.
That's called precision.
It's called damn luck.
That's a well-designed part. Thank you.
So we're gonna make a push bar in case of pig.
How are you push it if you're pulling?
What are you talking about?
What are you talking about?
So we got a big challenge here. They want to mount 3 separate wings. 2 big wings and a little wing on top. We have to make sure that all 3 wings are in the perfect place, and they have to match perfectly to the contour of the end plate. Not to mention the end plate has to be in the perfect spot too.
It's a thing.
Perhaps the biggest thing in the whole truck.
Be able to pull this thing out, push it around wherever we want, so we don't gotta push on the weak C pillar.
Edition. This is definitely the, like, who would build this?
We're putting the wheels on, and then we're gonna go do a couple burnouts, a couple races. We're gonna go rip it down. No, we're not gonna do that.
Oh man. That's it, that's the end of the
season. Ah, nice.
Cut this stupid spoiler out. These are the end plates that go over in the back. And I have 3 wings that go in it. I'm gonna cut a pocket into here. Insert the wings into it. Because this is hollow. Because that's like a compound curve. So wing inlets go like this, and they go like this. So it's super difficult to cut all 3 perfect. So the other way is to cut that.
See where we had the McDonald's ass roof.
Yo.
Oh.
No way. Yeah, we're dead.
All right, get in the driver's seat. Let's go.
Roll.
Fired up.
Fired up.
All right, you're good here.
We're good.
Ooh, it's wow.
All right, dump it. No.
We're not doing a dump.
You're good to bump. We're gonna hit it over now.
giant boom. That's cool, man. He realized I missed the first roll, so he came back and was like, Scott will be here for the first wheel slippage. I appreciate that.
That was awesome. Man, this thing feels so good. Feels so tight.
So wild that this came true.
Yeah. And it works.
I can't wait till this becomes like a hot wheel, you know? It's gonna be so good.
They can't get in the reverse. They're stuck in the gearbox and they put it in reverse.
On what we're seeing now, where I think we're at about 75%, which has gone down since Friday. It was like 85%. So I don't know. I think we're chilling.
You want to go to the beach?
The beach? Oh, dude, I went sailing yesterday. I got sick on the boat. Me in the ocean.
Did you throw up?
I did not throw up.
You got footage?
Hell no, I don't have footage.
He's got footage.
Cut to the footage.